Tonight, we thought we'd be talking about all of the elections still up in the air. After all, that process used in Minneapolis and St. Paul, ranked choice voting?
It does have a track record of taking days before we get the final results. But in Melvin Carter's case, a statistical phenomenon happened, and then something even greater, history was made. Here's Carla Holt.
Before it became a historic victory, it was an unpredicted one. Headlines warning a complicated ranked choice voting process may mean no results for days. I mean, honestly,
it is ranked choice voting.
I made the same call.
It is likely
just hours before
that we will not have a winner tonight.
Melvin made a statistical miracle happen.
Now, all along today, we've been talking about how final results will likely not be available for a few days, but that was with a caveat.
One candidate in a field of 10. Earning more than half the votes. Melvin did just that. Now enter the history.
How do you feel about being the first black mayor of the city of St. Paul?
I'm honored by just what voters said today. I'm honored by the opportunity to serve this city that raised me in so many ways.
In so many ways, starting so long ago.
I've shared with people all year that my family is fourth generation St. Paul. My great-grandparents came here from Texas fleeing racial violence in the Deep South. And I'm looking forward to the opportunity to build this city in a way that it truly works for every person and every part of it.
But what happened here last night, or more precisely, here? What drew voters to Melvin to deliver this fast and furious victory?
Well, the first thing I'll say is we spent the last 2 years listening to voters and talking to people. And in a city where I think too many people feel unheard, what we heard was just people all over the city who said, we have more to give.
People, Melvin says, who preach the need for opportunity.
We're eliminating the barriers that are blocking people from the prosperity, from participating in the prosperity of this greater city.
Now, a quick aside, I've covered elections for decades, watched the winning party celebrate their victory. But last night felt different, perhaps not unlike how the Obama supporters felt in 2008, or how those who fought against the marriage amendment felt in 2012. You had the sense that people in that room last night felt this was bigger than politics, and it had become a monumental moment in our social history.
This is unexpected, and this is incredible.
Incredible history. But let's keep it real. By meeting the mayor-elect's reality.
I feel great.
His family, his daughters, 11-year-old Milena.
I can learn more about, like, politics.
And 9-year-old Naomi.
Hello, St. Paul!
There you go. No more needs to be said.
Well, as you can see, right by that example right there, Mayor-elect Carter is taking a day off. Not doing any interviews and spending time with his wife and his kids, so that's
we
super
sent Carla
great.
To take a nap too. Who Carla. Was here till about 3 a.m. So
Carla emailed us at like 3:38 this morning, like, "Hey guys, hey, whatever."